Despite the extent of destruction the eruption of Indonesia's Lewotobi volcano has caused, its eruption is far from over, as its surroundings now face a new problem, specifically due to an advancing lava flow. A viscous basaltic andesite lava flow has quickly descended the west-northwest flank of the Laki-Laki cone, and, if it continues advancing at the same rate, will begin plowing through and then burning structures at 3:20 p.m. local time on November 13th. While most of these structures the lava flow could impact have already experienced some form of damage due to the falling lava bombs caused by the November 3rd and 4th eruption, they now risk complete destruction. The lava flow in question began during the afternoon of November 10th, quickly advancing downslope at a rate of 72 meters per hour. This rate thereafter declined due to the decreasing slope the viscous lava was flowing over, declining to 30 meters per hour. The lava eventually forked into two branches due to interacting with a local high point and terrain, and, as of the writing of this video, is 4 kilometers or 2.49 miles long at its longest point. This is only slightly shorter than the basaltic andesite lava flow Lewotobi in place during January and February earlier this year. However, an even larger problem than advancing lava flows became apparent during the evening of November 12th. A dramatic uptick in tremor began at 6 p.m., indicating that a plug had formed in the volcano's magma conduit. Soon, numerous earthquakes struck the region, being felt by many nearby residents. Loud rumbling soon became easily audible in a 14-kilometer radius, occurring alongside continuous tremors that everyone could feel. Due to the risk of what could easily become the largest eruption of Lewotobi so far, volcano monitoring staff quickly fled from the existing observatory building to the monitoring facility of a separate volcano further to the northeast. This occurred at 6:50 p.m., and as the loudness of the volcanic rumbling continued to escalate, PVMBG warned all locals beyond the current exclusion zone in an up to 10-kilometer radius in all directions surrounding the Laki-Laki cone that it might be best to evacuate. Then, at 11 p.m., the plug burst, but thankfully no catastrophic eruption occurred. Instead, a more than 500-meter or 1,640-foot-high lava fountain was generated, occurring alongside significant volcanic lightning and a moderate plume of ash which rose to an elevation of 15,000 feet. A crisis had seemingly been averted on one hand, and yet the aforementioned lava flow continued to advance downslope. This lava flow appears to be far thicker than would be expected from a basalt lava flow, suggesting that the basaltic component of magma that intruded underneath the volcano beginning on October 31st has largely erupted by now. What remains is more viscous basaltic andesite magma, hence the effusion of the recent lava flow. However, continuous magma supply is still being sent to the Laki-Laki cone, with more material being sent to the volcano than its magma conduit can reasonably accommodate. As a result, more plugs could still form, potentially resulting in additional major explosive events like witnessed on November 7th and 9th. Please, stay safe everyone. As a final note, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.